Hello, class 10 students of NCERT syllabus, CBSE syllabus, class 10 mathematics. Today we are going to study about Euclid's division lemma and the fundamental theorem of arithmetic. These are the two topics in the chapter 1 of NCERT textbook class 10 maths. And Euclid's division lemma, from lower classes you have studied different divisions. Suppose 26 divided by 5. 5 into 5, 25, remainder 1. And here, the 26, the number 26 you can write as 5 into 5 plus 1. That is, let the 26 be A, and this is B, and 2 plus R. And then, any positive integer, here positive integer is 26. And then we can write this number as divisor into quotient plus remainder. And this is very simple to understand, that we are making a small rule for that division process. And we are making a triangle, and known as Euclid's division lemma. Given positive integers A and B. Here the positive integer is 26, and B is a divisor, and Q is quotient, and R is a remainder. And given positive integers A and B, there exist unique integers Q and R satisfying A is equal to BQ plus R. R greater than or equal to 0, less than B. I will read once again. Given positive integers A and B, there exist unique integers Q and R satisfying A is equal to BQ plus R. R greater than or equal to 0, less than B. And there we can make so many examples. Another example is 324. 324, if we are dividing 324 divided by 8, four into eight, 32, remainder 0, bring down 4. And the 324, put a 0. And the remainder is 4. 324 is equal to 8 into 40 plus 4. A is equal to BQ plus R. Here, the given positive integer is 324. The divisor is 8. And the quotient is 40. And the remainder is 4. And so many examples, we can make so many examples connected with the Euclid's division lemma, Euclid's division algorithm. We will call this particular division rule by a different methods. Euclid's division lemma, Euclid's division algorithm. And so many examples of 324, here the number is 26. And it is very clear. Now, fundamental theorem of arithmetic. Every composite number can be expressed as a product of primes, and this prime expression is unique apart from the order in which the prime factors occur. For example, 8 you can write 2, 4, 2, 2, and 2 into 2 into 2, or 2 cubed. The number 8 we can write as 2 raised to the power of 3. Another example, that is 75. 75, we can divide by the first prime number 3. Then 25, another prime number is 5, 5. Then 75 is equal to 3 into 5 into 5. Or 3 into 5 square. And every composite, 8 is a composite number, 75 is a composite number, all these composite numbers can be expressed as a product of prime numbers. Here, 3 2s are there, 2 cube. How many 2s are the factors? 3 2s. And we can write the prime factors. 8a equal to 2 cube. 75 is equal to 3 into 5 square. And every composite number means numbers having more than 2 factors. And the prime number means numbers having only 2 factors, composite number. Prime number. You have to study. First you have to study what is prime number, what is composite number. Prime number having only 2 factors. For example, 2. 2 you can write 2 into 1 or 1 into 2. Only 2 factors. The number itself from the 1. Then 3, another prime number. 3 into 1 or 1 into 3. But a composite number, 8 is a composite number, you can write 8 is equal to 1 into 8. 8 is equal to 2 into 4. 8 is equal to 2 into 2 into 2. And in different ways, not only one factor. The factors are 1, 2, 4, 8. More than 2 factors. Such numbers are called a composite number. No? Okay. Thank you.